In the early hours of Wednesday morning, an ambulance brings Nigeria's president home. Umaru Yar'Adua has not been seen in public since he was rushed to a Saudi Arabian hospital because of a heart condition 3 months ago. No public comment has been made on his health, and it remains a closely guarded secret, much to the frustration of Nigerians.
Nobody would be happy to miss his father, because he's the father of the nation, and for 3 months, we cannot really say this is where he is. But the good thing is that he's back.
But they don't need to deceive Nigerians. You understand? He's our president, he's number one citizen of the country. Let him know how he is.
During President Yar'Adua's absence, the country has been faced with the military imposing a curfew across the north to control religious violence, militants ending a ceasefire in the oil-rich Niger Delta, and a constitutional crisis provoked by the president's absence. Vice President Goodluck Jonathan is acting president. But as this position remains unapproved by Nigeria's ministers, Goodluck has no constitutional basis to exercise power, leaving any action he takes open to challenge in court. It's a situation deliberately perpetuated, argues Nigerian human rights activist Wole Soyinka, for the benefit of the few.
The issue is that certain elements within the ruling party love this hiatus. They love the headlessness of government because they can proceed to loot and create their own little empires while the president is away.
In an interview before Yar'Adua's return, James Ibori, a leader of Nigeria's main ruling party, said the acting president is supported by the party, but he warned planned elections may be moved forward.
We arrived safely, sure, come 2011 elections, which I think, I don't know, depending on how the reform goes, might even be at the end of this year, if not very early next year.
But until then, not even Yar'Adua's return is expected to pull Nigeria out of the current chaos of uncertainty. Christian Purefoy, CNN, Lagos, Nigeria.